which have a powerful effect at releasing trapped energy and tight muscle. A little bit of gentle circular massage with the thumbs is really good, just to remove, help release the pecs from the sternum, warm the muscle up, and patiently sink in deeper and deeper into the muscle. How to work the pecs or the chest. First, you have to understand that when I am working the pecs or the chest, I never work it on its own. It would be part of a much larger session that would involve the neck, the shoulders, maybe the back and the arms. You see, the entire body is connected. So once you've worked the neck, I then start by working along the collarbone on the inside. These are where all the neck muscles attach. And we just want to work this gently, nice and softly. Not pressing on too hard, as that can affect the nerves, but just like pressing on and giving the collarbone a little bit of a gentle push, if you like, just to lightly mobilise it. Before working along the top of the traps, working into the pressure points of the gallbladder, which have a powerful effect at releasing trapped energy and tight muscles. This can be a lovely soothing effect, just catwalking into the traps, and all you're doing is leaning from one hand to the other, not using any force. And here I'm moving along the jawline. Now you've got to remember that the muscles from the neck that are connecting into the jaw, and then they're going down and they're connecting to where the chest is on the top of the pecs, especially the SCM, sternocleidomastoid mastoid, which can be very tight on a lot of people. So now we're just working the pressure points along the pecs on the other side of the collarbone. After this, I get some wax oil, lightly apply it, and then just gently massage it on. There's no specific technique here, I'm just warming the muscle up. Obviously, when you're working the pecs, with a man you can generally work a lot more, with a woman you're stuck to really working the upper pecs. Now this technique, using your knuckles, can feel incredibly relaxing, really nice to warm the upper pecs. So we're really getting the pectoral major here, but if you go a little bit deeper, you may be getting the pec minor a little bit. And again, this is just a really good technique to use the side of your hand, just to get all the attachments along the collarbone. Now you'll often find that when I'm working, I do jump from to muscle. So I'm feeling what's going on within the body. So I've decided there that after working a little bit on the chest, I really need to come back to them traps. So just giving the head a little stretch and taking the traps into a bit of a further stretch. Just rubbing my hands down them traps and extending the stretch a little. Thing when you're working any client is to listen to what the body is doing. Listen to what the muscle you're doing, listen to what the energy in the client's body is doing, and listen to them too. But sometimes what they're telling you isn't always the same as what the body's telling you. So this year is really good. I'm just working, doing some gentle massage at the top of the sternocleid mastoid, which does attach at the top of the pecs. And again, now we show the cat part, I mean, on the traps. Now this is exactly the same on the pecs, and it's really good for loosening the pecs up and stretching them out. Again, this is a lovely stretch to do on the fascia of the neck, just to help release the fascia behind the neck, release the muscles. It feels good. It's quite nice to do on someone too. You literally gently hold in the top of the head, slide your hands under the neck, lightly grasping the skin, just gently moving your hand back. Stretching the pecs away, just using light fascia. Lightly press on. And now just some a little bit of gentle circular massage with the thumbs. And again, back to that stretching end. So you can really see how my hand goes under, scoops the other side of the neck, and then I'm not pulling on my body, I'm not pulling on my strength, I'm just leaning back. It's hard to see that, but I am just leaning back. Again, now we're just using the flat of his fist. Don't tense your fist because it'll be too much. What we're going to do now is we're going to stretch the pecs. So we pin the pec down, keep the arm now nice and loose. Moving our arm through a range of different movements that will not only affect the pecs, but it'll affect the scapula and the subscapula. And as we do this, we're really stretching now the pec major and the pec minor. This can be very, very tender on people, especially people who are bodybuilders, so you have to be careful. What I'm doing with this is I'm just gently lifting her arm up, getting a little bit of shoulder mobility in there, helping to loosen up the joints. And again, just grasping hold of the collarbone, giving it a little bit of wiggle, trying to get a bit of movement in there, helping to release the muscle, to release the fascia. Personally, I think you should do this. It's always worth stretching and stretching again. And this stretch here will not only stretch pecs, but it'll also stretch the lats. So as you're pulling in this direction, it's really getting the lats. And then as you're bringing the arm more towards the head, that gets more of the pecs. So again, we're just moving that tissue away from the collarbone, trying to create a bit of space, trying to soften the muscle up, just releasing the pecs as we go. Now I'm always checking, always going back, always reassessing, seeing how the muscles feel, seeing if they stuck to the collarbone, seeing if there's any trigger points lurking around that we need to spend a little bit more time in. Now this year is really good just to remove, help release the pecs from the sternum. You have to be a little bit cautious with this. You can't really do it with clients with large breasts. Some female clients, I would ask permission on any female to do this. Some may not feel comfortable. It's a lot easier obviously to do this one on men. So again, I'm just working down, using pressure points down the side of the sternum. that will help release the pec from the sternum. Now, by now, I'll be expecting to feel some change going on. I'd expect to feel some of the tightness and some of the muscles starting to ease up. There that I'm working not just the pecs, but again I'm working to a larger extent, so I'm working down the arms, I'm working into the forearm, because you've got to think where the fascia runs. So most of the fascia of the arms runs from the chest, and then it runs down the biceps into the forearms. Interestingly, it's also where the lung meridian runs. So the lung meridian starts off just below the collarbone in lung one, and then it travels down the arm all the way to the thumb. But there's actually three main meridians that run down that side of the arm: the lung, the heart, and the heart protector. Just working the muscles just to keep them nice and soft before I come round to do any deeper work. Sinking in into them pressure points that are around the collarbone. So as I'm working here, I'm looking at what we call lung one. A really good pressure point, actually, if somebody's been suffering with grief, as well as clearing things like coughs and colds and helping with asthma. Basically just opening the chest up and helping you breathe. As well as working the chest, it's important that we work the shoulder, but the attachments, as you saw before on the other side. And now just grab hold of the collarbone, just do some slight mobilising of it, just moving it, trying to loosen up the muscles and the fascia that connect to the collarbone. Remember, as you can see, that I'm using my fist when going into the pec major. You'll notice that my fist isn't tense, it's kept relaxed. So not only is my fist relaxed, but my arms relaxed. The movement's coming from my body. It's not forcing my way into the muscle. I'm allowing my body to sink into the muscle. And that'll make a world of difference. When you're talking about whether massage hurts or whether it's uncomfortable, we can all pound away and really force his way into the muscle and have this client screaming on the table. It really doesn't achieve very much. It's far better to warm the muscle up and patiently sink in deeper and deeper into the muscle as the body allows you to. So again, you've just seen me doing the same pinning stretch. So we pin the muscle down, we're working the muscle in different angles. It really helps the chest, the pecs, both the pec major and minor, to release. You may find with a lot of your clients that a lot of them have rounded shoulders, and in order to deal with the shoulder pain that they actually have, first you've got to deal with the tightness in the chest. you release the tightness in the chest, and you'll more often than not ease the pain in the shoulders as well. So again, you'll notice as I'm carefully going across the sternum, just releasing the pecs a little bit from the sternum before coming along pressure points back on the chest again, and just gently working down the bicep, down the forearm again. Remember that the fascia of the arms and chest are all connected, running from the sternum all the way across the chest, down the arms to your fingertips. There is nothing in the body that isn't connected in some way. So again, just coming back now after working and releasing the chest to gently massage the neck. Feel amazing. How I like to work. I don't like to work in, you do one arm, then the other arm, then the back, then the leg, then the leg. I go back and forth, testing things, repeating things, checking things, feeling things, seeing how your body reacts to your touch. Sometimes you need to work an area and give it a few minutes to see if any change occurs before going back and working it again. And I hope you really enjoyed this video. And if you'd like more detailed videos like this and me talking about what I'm doing, please hit that like button and I will make more. So drop me a comment and tell me what you thought. Cheers guys, and don't forget, please do subscribe to this channel for more.